All right. Welcome back, ladies and the few gents that watch. In today's video, I am going to walk you through how I use ClickUp in my small business as a project management tool, specifically as an editorial calendar to help me keep everything organized, all the bits and parts of all of our content that we put out in one place out of my brain so that we can get things done more efficiently. We don't have to ever worry about forgetting things. We don't ever have to worry about feeling overwhelmed because our system is so well set up within this. I'm gonna actually jump into my ClickUp, walk you through what I do for our editorial calendar. This is gonna be specifically around our YouTube content because what we do with YouTube is then aggregate that out to other social media platforms and our blog. And so you'll be able to see our entire workflow throughout that entire process. All right, so within ClickUp, what you're gonna see here is that I have a space called YouTube Workflows. And then within that space, I actually just have one folder, but I could have set this up for multiple folders. And then within the folder, I have my different lists. My info and analytics is just my basic stuff that I might wanna keep handy. One thing that I do keep very handy is my YouTube keyword research and organization. So I actually keep this in my tray down here. And this is where I do a brain dump of ideas. So if I'm talking to someone on Facebook, if I'm talking to a client, if I hear, you know, a question that somebody's asking, if I see something else on YouTube that inspires an idea, what I'll actually do is come through and just drop ideas. And this is really, really helpful because when I first started, I was like, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to come up with an idea every month or every week. Like, it's just too much. And as you can tell, I have too many ideas. When you start this, you'll end up having, and then I have a whole bunch in comments as well. You just end up like having so many possibilities when you just start brain dumping ideas. So the first thing that I do is I come in here and I look through ideas and I try to find one that's viable. So I'm actually gonna do a little bit of keyword research on that, figure out what's a viable idea, and then I'm gonna go into my next step in the workflow to be able to organize that idea and get the content created. So I'll show you that workflow in just a second, but what you're gonna see here is just other random stuff that I might want to keep handy. This right here is just goals. Help me get there, guys. Help me get there. But basically where I spend most of my time is the in progress list. And what you're gonna see with in progress list is all of my status updates or my statuses for the task. And I'll show you what those look like in just a second. So at a glance, I can see where different things are in the promotion process or in the creation process of my content. So here's how I start. When I have the content idea, I'm gonna come into my workflow. This is my template that I've created. And this allows me to have everything all in one place. So you can see here, those statuses that I mentioned are actually, I've set them up as tasks so that I can easily see the tasks within each kind of category that we work within. So we created these for ourselves. So our organization, this is just me getting everything set up. When I do the keyword research and I put together our SEO information, I'm outlining a script. When I go to record, when we're doing the editing. And what's great about this is that we can assign this template out to everybody. So different tasks that are getting done by different people are gonna actually be assigned to those people. And then when I go to duplicate the task, it's gonna duplicate the assignees as well. The other thing that it's gonna duplicate, so you can see this in our editing, the other thing that it's gonna duplicate is any notes within each subtask. And we can turn those into a checklist also. So John, our editor, when he comes in and he's doing the final cut on the video, he's got this checklist here already where he can just go in and do the little things before he sends us the video. So this keeps things really organized and in one place. So we're not having to try to remember all the little tiny steps that need to be done. Another example of this would be something like our upload tasks. At one point we had all of our upload tasks as separate subtasks. After we kind of played with this for a little while, we realized that it's actually going to be a lot easier to have them all in one place. So we have the upload task and we have all of the individual tasks that go along with it. So let's say, for instance, that Crystal, my assistant, she's doing all these and she gets halfway through. Instead of marking this complete, she's just gonna change the due date of it so that she can come back and finish it up at another time. This keeps it more organized. So instead of her coming in and seeing 15 tasks on her list that day, she's seeing one task, but she knows they're all gonna get done in about 15 to 20 minutes because they're all grouped together. Once I duplicate this task, then I can go through and I can assign the due dates. So you can actually do this individually. So let's say I wanted to come over here and just set one due date for one task. Or for instance, let's say our first 24 hours, we know the video is gonna be, I don't know, let's say May 1st. I can actually go through and set the due date on all of these to be whatever date it is that I'm gonna be launching that video. So this just saves us some time because we can just within the template, or not within the template, once we duplicate the template, then we can go through and just quickly organize tasks and due dates and all of that. What's great about this is that when I go in and I organize everything, I set everything up, I then don't have to worry about it or think about it. I'm just going into my inbox in ClickUp every day and it's telling me what I need to do that day. So I come into my inbox and immediately I see, okay, I need to be recording videos today, or I need to be working on the keyword research today. And I'm not thinking about the whole scope of the project. I'm just focusing on what needs to be done that day. So this is my inbox right here. And this is an example of what it looks like. And you can see here, like it's just telling me, okay, I need to record A roll, B roll, and take a thumbnail for this video. So again, like the night before, I'm gonna be looking at my list and then I wake up knowing where my energy is gonna go and not spending any mental energy trying to figure it out. This is why I love templates so much. It frees up your creative brain so you can get in and actually do the things that need to get done and not spend energy trying to figure out what those things are. So let me show you the workflow for this video in particular. Right now it still says research because I haven't updated it, so I can actually update this to recording right now. And what I have here is my main YouTube drive. This is where we keep all of our files. I keep my notes for the video. We upload our teasers. The final video that comes from our editor goes in there. All of those things go into the main drive that's then broken down into folders. So we have our 18 content, 19 content, 20, and then I don't actually put the months in there until we're completely done with them. And so you can see in April is what I'm recording now. And generally what this will be is the actual keyword that I'm using in the video, but this hasn't been updated yet. And then we have our SEO doc. Now this folder in particular also goes here in the subfolder link. And then once the YouTube video is actually uploaded, that goes in the main description as well. So this subfolder link is linking to this. This document right here is linking to this. And then we just keep all of our tags, our title, thumbnail copy, keyword, pinned comment, all of it, our YouTube description, everything is in here. And most of this is already as a template. So we're just going in and you can see right here, like where it's red, we go in and we just fill in the blanks. I make edits to anything that might need an edit. If there is a particular content upgrade we're making, that's gonna go in here. The social media copy that's gonna go out and promote these videos, that will go in here. And then the scripts are gonna go in here. And actually this is the script for the last video that I did on ClickUp, which if you haven't seen that one, make sure you watch that one. It hasn't been updated yet because this is not actually scripted out. I'm just kind of walking you through, but you can kind of see an idea of what I'll end up doing. I just script everything out, usually in bullet points. That way it's nice and organized and I'm able to stay on track a little bit better in my videos. So you can see here, I haven't added the due dates, or I haven't finished adding due dates and assigning out the tasks. The signing out the task is actually done for this video, but we do have some that get assigned to different people depending on the content. So after this, I'm actually gonna be doing that, going in and assigning out all of the dates. And again, like I said, what we do is we work ourselves backwards. So we know that this video is gonna come out on the 21st. So all of these will get assigned to the 21st. These get assigned either within a couple days or within a week of the 21st. The last one I usually do about a week later, checking the analytics of the video. And then I work myself back up here So once this is done and uploaded and to our editor, I know his schedule because we've worked out our schedules together. And so I can then go in and schedule out his tasks. And then based on what I know his routine to be, we then schedule other tasks from that. So he's generally editing for us like on a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. We usually get the video back by Thursday, maybe Friday. And then we know from there we can start scheduling other tasks. So we do this several weeks in advance so that we have a cushion so that I can record, he can edit, and my assistant can get all the pieces together before the video is actually meant to launch. And that's it. Like I said, the biggest bonus of this is that it's getting it out of your brain. And you might be wondering, why does a Belief Breakthrough Coach talk so much about time management and organization and systems and processes? Because if you're keeping those things in your brain, you're gonna go crazy. We've all felt what it feels like to go and clean and organize your house and how that impacts your mindset, right? Your mental health. What our environment is will be a reflection of our inner environment and vice versa. Part of mindset work is to get things organized. If you wanna get your head straight, you need to get your life straight as well. You need to actually solve some of the organizational nightmares in your life so that you can free up brain power to be working on things like personal development or mindset change. So this is how I organize my editorial calendar. If you want to learn more about ClickUp, I did a video last week that goes more in depth on the pros, the cons, how to set it up. If you want to actually just jump right into it and play with it yourself, there's also a referral link below that I would love for you to use. And if you're brand new here and you love topics like mindset and getting your shizzy together, make sure to subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, drop me a comment to say hello, let me know what you liked about this video or what you would love to see more of, and be sure to share this video with other people that it might benefit as well. Thank you so much for being here, and I will see you in the next one.